Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika an ushrika bika wa ana a'lamu astaghfiruka liman a'lamu. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Ahabbati fillah. Continue on in our study of the difference between advising and condemning. Some of the other narrations I wanted to mention from the Salaf of this Ummah, showing that this is very important, that we're just and that our criticisms are based on knowledge when we refute one another, and we, even when we refute Ahl Bid'a, or if we refute the people of disbelief. Waqala Hassan ibn Rabi', qala ibn Mubarak, المعلى بن هلال هو إلا أنه إذا جاء الحديث يكذب قال فقال له بعد صوفية يا أبا عبد الرحمن تغتاب فقال اسكت إذا لم نبين كيف يعرف الحق من الباطل أو نحو هذا من الكلام. A beautiful statement, as was related by Hassan ibn Rabi' rahmatullah alayh, who said Ibn Mubarak rahmatullah alayh said Al-Ma'la ibn Hilal, he is nothing but a liar when it comes to hadith. When it comes to hadith, he only lies. And then he said, and it was said to him from some of the Sufiya. And the Sufiya here, I believe, is not mentioning what we generally refer to as Sufiya, as in people who take a minhaj based on a munharif, you know, a minhaj which goes against the sunnah, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and who are extreme in ibadah. But the Sufiya here, I believe, were referred to Ahl Suf, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. But in the narration, he said, فَقَالَ لَهُ بَعْدَ صُوفِيَّةَ. That some of the Sufiya, they said, O father of Abd al-Rahman, you backbited, you have backbitten. And then he said, be silent. If we do not make clear these affairs clear, then how will you be able to know, how will the people know between the truth and falsehood? Or something similar to this from his statements. This is very important, Habibti fillah. This shows us that the Salaf of this Ummah, that they didn't just regard that if someone made a mistake in the religion, they didn't let that just pass and say, oh, he made a mistake. And it isn't that they belittled the people, but rather they had to clarify those mistakes. If something is clearly a mistake or clearly a bid'ah, then it becomes impingent upon those people who have knowledge and the ability to do so to refute that mistake. Not necessarily refute speaking about the individual unless it becomes necessary. Unless it becomes necessary. And this is regard to those people with Ahl Sunnah. But when it comes to Ahl Bid'ah, then for sure you need to not just make it clear, but then the person is not held in esteem and respect because they're a person of desires aslan. Their usul in the religion goes against the minhaj of the Salaf of this Ummah, goes against the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered us with when he said, وَعْتِيُ اللَّهُ وَعْتِيُ رُسُولُ. قَالَ إِبْنْ أَبِي زَمَنِينَ لَمْ يَزَلْ أَهْلَ السُّنَّةِ يُعِيبُونَ أَهْلَ الْأَهْوَاءِ الْمُضَلَّةِ وَيَنْهُونَ عَنْ مُجَالَسَتِهِمْ وَيُخَوِّفُونَ فِتْنَتِهِمْ وَيُخْبِرُونَ بِخِلَافِهِ خلاقهم وَلَا يَرُونَ ذَلِكَ غِيبَ لَهُمْ وَلَا طَعْنًا عَلَيْهِمْ. So the last narration I want to mention, Ibn Abi Zamanin, he said, Ahl Sunnah does not cease to speak about the mistakes of the people of desires that are misguided, and belittle them, and prohibit from sitting in their gatherings, and that they instill fear in the people to warn the people from their fitna, and they tell the people about their manners and their ways. And they do not see this as ghiba, as backbiting of them, nor slandering them. And this is imperative. So we have to understand the difference between condemning and advising. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.